हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू माय चैनल पैथोलॉजी मास्टर। माय सेल्फ डॉक्टर पार्थ गोस्वामी, आई एम द कंसल्टेंट पैथोलॉजिस्ट एंड टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू टीच यू रिगार्डिंग द ट्यूबुलो इंटरस्टिशियल डिजीज। पर्टिकुलरली वी विल टॉक रिगार्डिंग द एक्यूट ट्यूबुलर नेक्रोसिस इन द डिटेल। सो गाइज, बिफोर आई स्टार्ट माई डिस्कशन ऑन द एक्यूट ट्यूबुलर नेक्रोसिस, आई रिक्वेस्ट यू टू सी द वीडियो रिगार्डिंग द रीनल सेल कार्सिनोमा दैट वॉज पोस्टेड बाई मी बिफोर 3 to 4 days, सो दैट you can easily understand today's lecture. All right. So guys, this particular topic comes under competency number 28.3, 28.8 and 28.9, in which we will learn regarding the tubulo interstitial disease and the acute tubular necrosis. All right. So guys, first of all, you should be familiar with the function of kidney. So you know very well that kidney is doing the function of regulating the salt and water concentration in our body, right? Then it will eliminate your waste products and it will secrete one hormone, that is erythropoietin, which is helpful in red blood cell production. So these three are the main function of the kidney. Let's move ahead. So guys, to understand the pathology of kidney, a Robbins book has divided the pathology into 4 portions. One portion is glomerular disease. The example of glomerular disease is glomerulonephritis. Second portion is tubulo interstitial disease, in which the examples include acute tubular necrosis and tubulo interstitial nephritis, which is our today's lecture. And third portion is disease involving the blood vessel of the kidney, like that of arteriosclerosis. And fourth one is tumor of kidney. We have already discussed regarding the all tumors of kidney in my previous lecture. And today I am going to teach you tubulo interstitial disease, particularly acute tubular necrosis. So this lecture will be divided into 2 portions. Today we will learn acute tubular necrosis in detail. Okay. So guys, this is the basic cross section of the kidney, that is showing the basic anatomy of the kidney. Now I have already described the anatomy of kidney in the detail in my previous video of renal cell carcinoma. So we will just outline the anatomy here. The outer portion is the covering capsule. Below capsule you will have your cortex. So this is your cortex area, right? Below cortex you have the medulla. This is your medulla portion. Okay, all right. Now this triangular structure is your renal pyramids, right, which will open into renal papilla. Through the renal papilla it will open into the minor calyces. So this is your minor calyces, right? These all are your minor calyces. And below minor calyces you have your major calyces. This is your major calyces, which open into renal pelvis, and finally it will open into collecting duct. So this is the basic anatomy of the kidney. We will not discuss it in detail because it was already discussed. All right. So guys, tubulo interstitial disease is divided into 5 portions. Okay, the first one is acute tubular necrosis. Second one is tubulo interstitial nephritis. Third one is urate nephropathy. Fourth one is hypercalcemia induced nephropathy. And fifth one is multiple myeloma effect over the kidney. So these 5 are your basic tubulo interstitial disease. And today we will discuss in the detail regarding the acute tubular necrosis. The rest of the portion will be covered in the next lecture. All right. So guys, you know very well that this is your tubules, right? This is your proximal and distal convoluted tubule in the kidney. And in between the tubule, you have the interstitium. So disease involving these 2 portions is known as a tubulo interstitial disease. So let's start our today's topic of discussion of acute tubular necrosis. So we will discuss regarding the acute tubular necrosis. So guys, the name itself suggests, here you have the acute renal shutdown, you will have the acute disease, so you will develop acute renal failure in the acute tubular necrosis, and because of acute renal failure, there will be rapid reduction of the renal function, and so your urine output will be reduced. And guys, name itself suggests that here you will have acute injury of the tubules. You will have the cell death of your tubules. So the tubular epithelium will get damaged in the acute tubular necrosis. Your tubules epithelium will be damaged. Particularly, it will damage your proximal tubules. The proximal tubules are affected most commonly, that is PCT. So you will have the epithelial damage and your renal will get failed. So you will have acute renal failure if acute tubular necrosis developed. Alright. If we talk regarding the pathogenesis of acute kidney injury or ATN, then there are two basic pathogenetic mechanisms that will lead to kidney injury. The first one is reduction in the blood flow, that is ischemia. And the second one is nephrotoxicity by certain nephrotoxic substance. So either you can have nephrotoxic injury or you can have kidney injury due to reduction in the blood flow. These two can be pathogenetic mechanism. We will see the each cause in the detail in this slide. So this particular diagram showing you the etiology of acute tubular necrosis. Alright. So first one is your ischemia, right? The first cause is ischemia. So guys, can you imagine when you can have ischemia in the kidney? When the renal blood flow will be decreased. Obviously, the causes can be two. Either you can have disease in your renal blood vessel, right? Either you can have disease in your renal blood vessel, or you can have reduction in the effective circulating blood volume. So the disease of the renal blood vessel is called as a vasculitis. Particular, the cause for acute tubular necrosis is vasculitis, particularly microscopic polyangiitis. Or you can have malignant hypertension. You can have the malignant nephrosclerosis in the kidney, and that can lead to acute tubular necrosis. Or other example is DIC, that is disseminated intravascular coagulation. So it can lead to the disease of renal blood vessel can lead to acute tubular necrosis. Alright. Now when you can have a reduction in the effective circulating blood volume. So your blood volume will get reduced whenever there will be massive hemorrhage. If your blood is getting lost via accidents or due to injury during the surgery, right? If your vessels are getting damaged during surgery, then you can have the massive hemorrhage. Okay. Your blood volume will get reduced if you have the excessive loss of fluid from your body, particularly in case of severe burns, dehydrations, or prolonged diarrhea. In such condition, you can have fluid loss. And the third cause is septic shock and congestive heart failure, in which your effective circulating blood volume will be reduced. So because of these two conditions, you can have ischemia, and that ischemia will lead to acute tubular necrosis. We will see how pathogenesis works, how ATN develop. We will see it in the detail later on in the slides. Okay. The second important cause is nephrotoxicity by certain nephrotoxic substance. So that is the second important cause of acute tubular necrosis, right? So that nephrotoxic substance includes certain antibiotics like that of aminoglycosides, gentamicin, right? If it is given in excessive dose, then it can damage your tubules. Amphotericin B, that is antifungal drug. If given excessively, then it can lead to ATN. Certain heavy metal exposure can lead to acute tubular necrosis like that of mercury, lead, or cisplatin exposure. There can be tubular damage because of carbon tetrachloride or ethylene glycol like organic solvent toxicity. And finally, radiation can lead to toxicity, can lead to damage of your tubules. Alright. The third cause is mixture of ischemia and nephrotoxic substance both. That example include mismatch blood transfusion. If wrong blood is given to you, then you can develop a blood transfusion reaction and your kidney can get damaged. Certain hemolytic disease, particularly sickle cell anemia crisis, can lead to kidney damage. Or skeletal muscle injury can lead to tubular damage as well. So this is the third cause. The fourth one is obstructive cause. If you have the urinary obstruction, then you can develop acute tubular necrosis. These obstructive cause include either tumors in your kidney area, or you can have prostatic hypertrophy that can lead to urinary obstruction and ATN. So guys, these four are the causes of acute tubular necrosis. First one is ischemia, second one is nephrotoxic substance, third one is combination of both ischemia and nephrotoxic substance, and the fourth one is urinary obstruction. These four can be the cause of your kidney injury, particularly acute tubular necrosis. Alright guys, so this is again the repetition of the etiology. This is the outline. The causes can be ischemia, there can be direct axillary toxic injury, there can be hypertension, or there can be skeletal muscle injury. The DIC and urinary obstruction also can lead to acute tubular necrosis. Now guys, you should know that this acute tubular necrosis is the most common cause for development of acute renal failure. Acute renal shutdown in the 50% case is due to acute tubular necrosis. So this is the important cause of acute renal failure. Okay. Alright. So guys, this is a very beautiful diagram that is given in the Harshmohan textbook of pathology, which showing you the pathogenesis of acute tubular necrosis, and it's the master diagram to understand this whole lecture. So guys, you know very well that acute tubular necrosis develop mainly because of two reasons. The first one is ischemia and the second one is nephrotoxic substance. So we will see how pathogenesis of ATN develop in both these etiology. So first of all, on the right side you have the nephrotoxic substance. Now this nephrotoxic substance can lead to direct tubular damage. Your proximal convoluted tubule will directly get damaged, and so you will have the tubular necrosis. That is the easily understandable pathogenesis, that nephrotoxic substance will damage your tubules. Now on the left side you have the ischemia. So guys, in the ischemia, what happened? Because of ischemic cause, you will have the less renal blood supply, and because of the less renal blood supply, your renin-angiotensin system will get activated. You know very well that whenever blood supply to the kidney is less, the renin-angiotensin system is getting activated, and because of activation of this system, your artery will get constricted. So there will be vasoconstriction, and because of vasoconstriction, the ischemia is aggravated, and so you will develop more tubular necrosis. So the ischemia can lead to tubular necrosis in that way, right? Alright. Now because of tubular necrosis, your glomerular filtration rate will get reduced, and so your urine output will be reduced, right? And so you will develop acute renal failure. Alright. Now what happened? Because of acute tubular necrosis. Now until now it is clear that how tubular necrosis develop in both these cause, right? But because of tubular necrosis, your tubular epithelium will get damaged. So the damaged epithelium, the damaged epithelial debris will get released into your tubules, right? It will slough into the tubular lumen and it will form the cast. So there will be development of cast because of desquamated epithelial debris in the tubular necrosis, and this cast will get collected in the tubules subsequently. Suppose this is your tubule and you have the sloughed epithelium, right? So it will gradually get collected in your tubules and they will form the cast. So ultimately what happened? Because of collection of these epithelial debris, the tubular pressure will get increased, so it will damage your tubular epithelium. This epithelium will get damaged, and because of damage of the basement membrane of tubules, there will be tubular rupture, right? So the content will released into nearby interstitium, right? The content will released in interstitium, and you know that whenever there is any damage, your body will show the inflammatory response, and so as your epithelial debris is released in the interstitium, you will have the inflammatory response in the interstitium. So you will develop tubulo interstitial inflammation. So we can say that in the acute tubular necrosis, there are two particular main findings can be seen. The one is damaged epithelium will released in the tubular lumen, and so there will be sloughed epithelium in the tubular lumen. That is, that will form the cast. So tubular cast will form, and finally you can have the inflammatory response in the tubulo interstitium. So you will have tubulo interstitial inflammation as well. These two are the main finding in acute tubular necrosis. This is the same diagram showing you the same pathogenetic mechanism. Alright, so now until now we have seen the etiopathogenesis of acute tubular necrosis. Now we will see the morphology of acute tubular necrosis in the detail. So you know that morphology include two important finding, gross as well as microscopic finding. So guys, you have to remember that this is the disease of tubulo interstitium. So glomerulus and blood vessel are absolutely normal. There will be problem in the tubulo interstitium area. So grossly, if we look at the kidney, then grossly your kidney will be swollen. The size of kidney will get increased. Your cortex will be pale, and your medulla is getting congested. So the medulla is congested. You can see in the diagram that cortex is absolutely pale. And this is the medulla, right? It is a very bright red colored. So your medulla will get congested. So this is the gross finding of acute tubular necrosis. Now if we talk regarding the microscopic finding, then obviously, as we have discussed in the pathogenesis, you will have the damage of the tubular epithelium. Suppose this is your tubule, right? So this epithelium will get damaged. And because of damage in the tubular epithelium, it will get released into the tubular lumen. So you will have the sloughed epithelium in the tubular lumen, and that will form the hyaline and pigmented granular cast. So the hyaline cast and pigmented granular cast can be seen. And we know that because of subsequent collection of the epithelial debris, your tubules are getting damaged, and so because of that damage, the contents will get released in the interstitium, and so you will have the interstitial inflammation. So microscopically you can see two important findings. The first one is necrotic epithelial cell that will slough into the lumina. In the diagram you can see that this is your tubule, guys. Just see, this is your tubule, and in the tubule you have the sloughed necrotic tubular epithelium. So the tubular epithelium will get damaged, will get necrosed, and that necrotic debris can be seen in tubules. Ultimately they will form the cast, right? So we can say that this is the most important finding seen in the acute tubular necrosis, that is the necrotic epithelial cell that will slough into your lumina. And it is the most important MCQ, guys. You have to remember that. And second important finding is you will have obviously the inflammation in the interstitium when the tubules are getting damaged. So you will have tubulo interstitial inflammation. Alright. Now suppose if ischemia is not that much severe. In that condition, if ischemia is of low degree, right, then you will have the vacuolar degeneration of the lining epithelium. There can be vacuoles, right, because it is a reversible cell injury. If the ischemia is less, then you will have the reversible cell injury, and then you will have vacuolated epithelial cells. But ultimate finding is necrotic epithelial cell that will slough into the lumen of tubules. Alright. Okay, so we have discussed regarding the morphology of acute tubular necrosis. Now we will see the clinical course of this acute tubular necrosis, how the patient will present to you. So guys, if there is an acute kidney injury or acute tubular necrosis, then urine output will get reduced because you have the acute renal failure. And because of the decrease in the urine output, your blood urea nitrogen will get increased. So we can say that the waste product will not get eliminated by the kidney, and subsequently they will get collected. So you will have increased blood urea nitrogen and creatinine level. And ultimately you will enter into the maintenance phase, in which your urine output will further reduce, and because of the increase in blood urea nitrogen creatinine like waste product, you will develop metabolic acidosis and hyperkalemia, right? So you will develop metabolic acidosis. Okay, so until now in this maintenance phase, if you have not done the treatment, if you have not treated the underlying cause, then there can be acute renal failure and you can enter into multi-organ dysfunction. Your brain also can get affected. But if you induce the treatment at this phase, if you treat the uremia and if you treat the underlying cause, then finally you will recover, in which your urine output will get increased. But still you have the damaged tubules, so the sodium and potassium like salts will not get reabsorbed and it will lost in your urine. So you can develop hyponatremia or hypokalemia in the recovery phase. So this is the three important clinical course seen in the acute tubular necrosis. Alright, so guys, this diagram showing you the main causes of acute renal failure and urine analysis finding in all these cases. So as we have discussed, the most important cause of acute renal failure is ATN, that is acute tubular necrosis, in which you can see the necrotic epithelial cell into the lumen of tubules and that will ultimately form brown color cast or hyaline cast. The second cause of acute renal failure is acute glomerulonephritis, which we will discuss later on in the lectures, right? So second cause is acute glomerulonephritis, in which you can have RBC cast, red blood cell cast is seen. Third important cause of acute renal failure is acute tubulointerstitial nephritis, in which in the urine you will see the WBC cast. So these are the important MCQs, right? Brown cast is seen in ATN, RBC cast is particularly seen in acute glomerulonephritis, and WBC cast are particularly seen in acute tubulointerstitial nephritis. Alright, so guys, we have discussed etiopathogenesis, morphology and clinical feature of acute tubular necrosis in our today's topic of discussion, right? Hope you can understand this lecture very well. Now again I am summarizing, guys, because this is very important master diagram. There are two important causes of acute tubular necrosis. One is ischemia and another one is nephrotoxic substance. Nephrotoxic substance will directly lead to tubular damage and so you will have tubular necrosis. Now because of ischemia, you will have renal angiotensin system activation that will lead to vasoconstriction of your renal vessel, and because of vasoconstriction you can further aggravate your tubular ischemia that will lead to necrosis. Now this necrotic debris will slough into the tubular lumen that will form the cast. Ultimately it will obstruct your tubule and so the tubular pressure will get increased that will damage your tubular basement membrane, and because of rupture of that tubule, because of increased pressure, tubule is getting damaged. And so because of rupture of the tubule, the content will get released in the interstitium. So you will have tubulointerstitial inflammation because of damage, right? So these are the two important findings seen in acute tubular necrosis. One is necrotic epithelial cells sloughed into your lumen and so there will be cast formation, and the second one is tubulointerstitial inflammation. So guys, this is all about the acute tubular necrosis. This is my reference for the today's lecture. Hope you have enjoyed the video. If you like my video, then subscribe my channel and press the bell icon so that you can get notified whenever I am posting the new videos. Alright guys, now in my next topic of discussion, I will cover remaining aspects of tubulointerstitial disease. Particularly, we will discuss regarding the tubulointerstitial nephritis in the detail, in which we will discuss pyelonephritis, which is very important topic. So until then, stay tuned and good night. See you soon guys. Thank you very much for listening.